Okay, so we'll see about the analytical functions today. So we left only with this only, right? We left with only this analytical function. So as we oracular analytical functions calculates an aggregate value based on the group of rows and return multiple rows. So group functions will return only one value for each and every group. Okay, for each and every group we'll get only one value. Okay, here you will get the multiple values. Okay, for that particular group, whatever the values we have, so we'll get all the values. Okay, so we have different types of functions here, analytical functions, rank, density rank. Okay, so what is the rank and what is the density rank? We will see each and every one. Here, I'm connecting with the HR schema. Now, I need to provide the ranks. How the students is getting the ranks in the 10th, and now the education system is changed with the grades. So how the grades is calculating? Okay, based on some range of values. So now here, see, now we have the salaries here. I need to provide the ranks. Treat, like I said, this salary column as a marks column. Okay, who is having the maximum marks, who is having the minimum marks? So I need to provide the ranks, either ascending format, either descending format. To provide that, we have the rank function. E dot star or emb dot star. Just I am providing some alias name. Just I am referring that as a table name. So for this employee table, whatever the columns we have, take that all columns. That's what I'm going to explain to the system here. Okay, later. So here we have the rank function. So rank is the function, rank function. So we have analytical function in the sense that function must contain the over class, over. Partition by. Okay, now remove this partition by class. We will see about this partition later. So now what I'm going to do here is I need to provide the ranks in ascending order or descending order based on your requirement. So if you want to provide the ascending, so provide that. So low to high, you need to provide the grades or ranks. Treat like as a RNK. Now, see here, 800, 950 to 1103, 1254. Okay, now, like after 1250, what the value we have? 1300. You will expect it for 1300, you need to expect the 5 for this rank. Okay, so you are missing some rank between one rank to another rank. So you are missing some ranks in the consecutive ranks, consecutive in the sense. Sequence of the ranks you will get right in between. So you may miss some ranks if you have the common values, common marks. If any student got any two students or five students have the same marks, so you will miss like a four ranks. Okay, so now we have this rank function. Okay, now I am running with another function. We have another analytical function, density rank, density score rank. Same thing, or nothing here, just I'm instead of rank function, I'm using the density function, density underscore rank. Okay, so see, to understand that, d underscore rnk, I'm make it like this. See here, one. This is the salary column, 1100, 1950, 1100 same, 1250 same, 1250 same, 1300. In the rank function, you are getting 6. In the density rank function, you are getting the 5. So you are not missing any ranks between. If you have the common, if you don't have the common value also, you will get the correct ranks or accurate ranks. Okay, that's why we'll go with the density rank. Okay, so we have another function, nothing difference here. So if you are the definitely the interviewer asked this question like, what is the difference between rank and the density rank? Rank and the density rank. Okay, so the similar way, we have another function, row underscore number. Row underscore number, same, nothing I'm doing here, order by salary ascending. Okay, now I'm just simply mentioning R and O. Okay, see, you observe the things here. 1800, you don't have any discrepancy. 950, no problem. 1100, no problem. 1250. For 1250, 444. Okay. Another 1250, you got 44 in the, this both, you have the correct value. Okay. So, whereas in the row number function, you are getting the different value. Okay, if you have the common value, if you don't have, if it is a different value, it won't bother about that. It simply generate the, for each and every row as a different row number, sequence number. Okay, so for this 1250, now for this 1250, who is this 12 for Ward and Martin? So now you got the Martin for 4 years, right? For four. So Martin, you got the 5, Ward, you got 4. So if you run the multiple times, it may change. So Ward can get the 5, Martin can get the 4. Got it right? You don't have any sequence here. There is a common order. So if someone is having the 90-90 marks, okay, if you have 90-90 marks, if one of the invigilator is providing the ranks, okay, if someone is provided now, he can provide that for one person, X person was a 1 and Y person may be 2. Okay, if the same ranks is provided by the another invigilator, so in the re-verification or revaluation, in that there is a chance to get the, if both the people having the same rank, he can prioritize that by caste wise or anything. Got it right? So definitely about these three functions, you may get at least one interview question. Okay. So this is about the rank and density rank and the row number. Okay. We have other things. We already seen about the first value, last value, lag and lead. So lag will help you, lag function. We are lagging that the previous record. So if you want to get the previous transaction value to the current transactions, we will use the lag function. Okay, lead function. So if you want to take the next transaction to the current transaction, we'll use the lead. Okay, that is the difference. Everything will same. Okay, count. Now we have these functions, right? Now I need cumulative sum. Cumulative sum in the sense, now we have the 800, right? So if another employee is giant, how much I am making the payment from this employee till this employee? 800 plus 950. So I need to show as a cumulative sum. For this first record, I need to show cumulative sum as 800. Okay, for next employee I join, right? 800 plus 950, I need to show that 1750. Okay, so another we have third employee 1100, 1750 plus 11, 1850, 2850, I need to display. Okay, I need to sum the, what are the previous values I have? 800 plus 950 plus 1100, I need to show this. Okay, if I go with the fourth record, I need to, prior of the, what are the transactions we have, I need to sum that, I need to display that value. Okay, how to get the cumulative sums for each and every record. Okay, now we'll use the function like a sum, analytical function, sum of salary. If I use this, it give the error. It give the error because it's an aggregate function or group function. It's not the analytical function. If you want to run this function, we need to use this all the columns in the group by class. Okay, so it won't run. So you are using the analytical functions here again. If you are using the analytical function, you cannot able to use the aggregate functions in the group by class. Okay, now I make it like this is a sum function as the analytical function over thereby MP number D. Okay, else we will go with the salary only, then you can understand better. Now we have the cumulative sums here. See, okay, 800. First record it is showing the cumulative sum as 800. Okay, 800 plus 950, 1750. 800 plus 950 plus 1100, it will show the like this. Okay, this is, we can call it as a cumulative sum. So if you want to get the cumulative sum, we need to use the sum analytical function, not aggregate function. Okay, so these are the analytical functions. We finish out the functions. Okay, first value. So now first underscore value. Okay, same thing. Make it like I say. Ascending. ASC meaning is ascending. We no need to use if you want to make it like as a descending. So if you want to make it like as a low to high, we need to mention the ascending. So if you haven't mentioned anything, by default it will treat like as ascending. So if I mention these or not, it won't bother about that. You will get the same results. If you mentioned or not, it won't bother. If you want to make it like I say descending, you need to definitely, you need to mention that DSC descending. Now see, now I'm trying to get the, you are trying to get the, what is the first value for that salary? Okay, now see, what the first value we have in this group of list?
Yeah.
8. You are getting for that 800 value for all the records. That's why. Okay, first value, last value. If you need that, you use the descending. You will get the 5,000. Got it? This is about the analytical functions. Okay, we'll finish it about the classes. Definitely I will say, man, without classes I can't move to the like functions. Okay, no problem, we'll finish it today about that. Okay, classes. So we'll see about the classes today. Okay, so classes we have, these are all the classes we have. So we know select class, from is the class, where is the class, group is the class, having, count, order by, distinct. These are all the different types of classes. To work with these queries, we need to know about the classes. We need to know about the classes. Select. Start from employee. Now, I'm dropping this last name column. So, alter. Take it. Okay, it is not working like you are expecting. It is not working. Okay. So instead of that column, simply make it like a bracket. It is also work. It will also work. Okay. Now I drop that. Okay, now we have the required columns here. Now what I'm learning is, now what we are going to see, this is the class. Select is the class, from is the class. So these two classes are the mandatory, compulsory. If you are writing any query, these two are the mandatory classes. These two are the mandatory classes. So here, without this, any one of the class are EMP. So from keyword, not found, where expected. You are expecting the from keyword. You don't have that. Now, again, I'm running this. From keyword, not found. Sorry, select command. Unknown command. Okay. System cannot understand that. Okay. So these are the two important mandatory classes. We have other classes here. So now we have the 14 records here. Now I need only the employee name is having with the Scott. Now I need to retrieve only where ename equals to you are filtering the data from the table. You want to filter the data. So while retrieving the data from the table, you want to filter something. Okay, so you are going for the shopping. So you need to filter out. So while filtering that, while choosing your shopping, so I need to purchase my pants, I need to purchase one night pant, I need to buy shirts and everything. So there is a ladies, like else you will go treat like as a lady shopping, gent shopping. So there is some variation. You will choose that based on your requirement. Okay. So if you go with central, you may have the lot of floors. This is for the ladies corner. This is gents corner. This is kids corner. You can choose that. So you want to purchase your things, you will go with the gents corner. You want to... You don't need that ladies corner and kids corner. In the similar way, if you want to get the data from the table, required information, if you want to filter or pull, we'll use the where class. Where is the class to filter out the data from the tables? Okay. This is optional class. It's not a mandatory. So without this class also, you may get the data. But it replaces the whole information. So if I want to, if I want to get the required things, we'll use this. Okay, so this is about the where class. We have another classes. So yesterday we see about the, we saw about a group by class. Now we have the employee details of 14 employee information. Now I need to make it like as a department wise group. Department wise, I need to find out how many employees I have. So you need to count that. So we'll use the count function. If I run this, you will get the error. This is the count function. If you are using the count functions, other than the count functions are grouped columns. Whatever the columns we have in the select list, that columns must and should be in a group by class. Now I'm counting this number of employees. Okay, now we are counting that number of employees. So If you want to filter the data from the base tables, we'll use the from class. Now, if you want to count the data, now I make it as a group. Department wise, I make it as a group. Department wise, how many employees are working? So make it some alias name for this. Number of employees, EMP working. This is alias name. Column alias name. Okay, this is table alias name. Okay, so now select staff from employee where e name equal to Scott. So now we counted this, right? Now we find out the group by using group that you are counting the number of employees. This will help for this only, nothing here. Now, if you want to make it the any group based on one column, based on two column, three column, five column, based on your requirement, you will use this. Okay, so now I need to filter the data. I need to filter this result. So what are the things you perform with the group by class? You got some results, these three records. Okay, I need to filter out. So who is, which department is having more than five employees? I need to display that information only. Need to display that information having one star greater than five. Okay, if you want to filter out the results, whatever the things you perform with a group by class, you will get some results, right? On top of that results, if you want to filter anything, if you want to choose required data from the result, we'll use the having class. Okay, so difference between where class and having class. Where class is used to filter the data from the base tables. Having class is used to filter the data from the grouping result. Okay, in the where class, you can able to use the normal call. If you want to use like a count star greater than five. Group function is not allowed here. You cannot able to use the group functions in where class. In the where having class, you can able to use the group by class, sorry, group of columns or group of functions. These two are the differences. Okay, so we are left with the only having class, sorry, order by class. Now, we already know what is order by class. Now we have the employee information here. Now I need to sort the data. See here, 800, 1600, 1250. There is no order for this data. Now I need to make it as order. Order by salary descending from 5000 to 800. I need to sort the data. Okay, so now we have this grades. Now we sorted out the salary, right? Now I'm sorting out by department number. Department number wise, I'm sorting the data. See here, first 10th department employees have the first. In the first place, in the second we have the 20th and 30th we have the this. Okay, now I am going to sort the data using the e name CKM. Okay, it's in the order only, no need to worry. So in the second 20th department, JF Adams Smith Scott Ward, right? So Scott, These are all the not in order. Okay. I need to make it as an order. Okay. So now department number, comma, unit. So I'm not mentioning either ascending or descending. So now the system can treat like I say ascending. Now see, now the ename is here. Okay, C K M. See here, A F J S S S C S S C is the small, right? That's why you are getting, you got the sorted data now. If you want to sort the data based on two columns, how that sorting will happen? So what are the first column you are mentioning? It mentioned the what are the different types of values. It make it as a group for that. See, we have three different values. It make it as a three groups here. On that particular group, you are sorting the data again. So this have this group having three records. It's sorting the data for this three. Okay. This is about the order by class. We have another thing you need to know here. Okay. So now we are sorting that based on some value. Now we will sort about the commission value. Now I am sorting that order by commission column. Now see 0, 300, 500, you got that. But null values, all null values are the last. Okay. Now if I see, if I use the descending, nulls will become first. Nulls will become first. Okay, we need to change that priority. You need to make it as a nulls last. In ascending also, except in descending also, if you want to make it nulls going to last. See, nulls has been adjusted with the last. Nulls is adjusted with the last. Understand, right? Nulls have the first and the last options both. Nulls first, nulls last. Okay? So, nulls first, nulls last. This will help you while dealing with null values. We need to prioritize for the null or different values. We will use that. Okay. So this is about the order by class. Okay. We have select star from EMP. Union. If I run this query, how many records I will get here?
Total 20 internal.
Okay, we get the 28 records. Okay, now we have the table like a create table. EMP underscore dupe. I'll make it like as a sum table for this. Okay, select star from EMP underscore do. Now we have the different values for this. Okay. Now we have the distinct values. See, this record is entire record as a duplicate. Now I need to eliminate the duplicate records. And the result, not from the table, simply use the distinct keyword, distinct star. Distinct is the class to eliminate the duplicates from the result, not from the table. If you remove this, you will get the duplicates again. Use the distinct class, it eliminate the duplicate values from the result. Distinct and inequal also. We won't use the inequal. And you need to know. Okay. So this is about the. Okay, so now we'll see about the some pseudo columns here. Pseudo columns. I will let you know by the later we have the sequence concept. We'll see about that. Now we have the. What are the columns we have here? EMP number, ENM, job, and we have the 8 columns here. You can choose any one of these columns, correct? So now EMP number. I'm getting the data. I'm make it like as a EMP number 1. It is showing invalid identifier. So you are trying to select the column, whatever the column is you are going to select, that is not present in the actual table. That is not the part of the actual table column. See, EMP number we have, EMP number 1 is not there in this. Okay, so you are getting the error for that. Okay, now row number, we are not getting the error here. The row number is present in this column or in this result, do you have any row number column? Not right. So row number is a pseudo column. Pseudo column in the sense there is a well and a mirage. Well and mirage. So mirage will, if you are walking on the road in the like afternoon 12 at 1 o'clock, you will look like as if there is a water in the road. If you go to that place, you won't see that water. That is called mirage. Okay, so similar kind, but there is not, you are not able to see that. You cannot able to catch that, I mean touch that, but you can able to see that from the long. In the similar kind, you can able to see that row number is a pseudo column to get the data about that. It simply provide the sequence number for each and every row. How the data you inserted, what is the first record? Second record, third record, in a similar way. See here, 7369 is the first record, it will be 15th also the same record. Okay. So row number, it provides the sequence number for each and every record. Okay, now we have another thing like a row ID. So it's a address ID. See, it's a 18 digit number. It's a 18 digit number. See, everything will say AAA, AAA, right? Here, see, AAB, AAC, AAD, AAD. Okay, so this is the pseudo call. Row number will help you to get the sequence number for each and every row. Row ID, it will give the address ID. So this is the address ID, just how that government is providing the Aadhaar number for you. It's a permanent Aadhaar number for you. If you die, if you alive, so that number won't give to any other person. Meaning is, if you delete the record, so now if I delete the 7369 record, okay, so you cannot able to adjust with this record as a AA. So if you someone died, if your grandpa and someone died, that Aadhaar number won't adjust for your grandchild. That will be same for that guy only. Any queue number for each and every member. Okay. So what is the row ID is the address ID. So what is the meaning of the address ID? You know, if the data is stored in the database, where in the table, okay, the data gets stored in the table. So where the table is stored, in the table space, where the table space has been created, in the file system, hard disk or file system. You can treat like as hard disk. We won't talk about it in the real time case. We'll say it as a file system. So for the file system having some address ID, exactly where the data is stored in that file system. So where that record is stored in that, exactly that file system. That we can make it like, that we can call it as a address ID. Row ID is the where that record is physically stored in the file system that has some address ID, that is the row ID. Okay, take your Aadhaar number and get the address, your address, and put it in the Google, and finding it is very easy for you. If someone need to find, if you have Aadhaar number, get it in the government UPID.government, in that you can get some address for that Aadhaar number, and search in the Google, and you will go to the that directly that person. Okay, so row ID is that, row ID, row number is that, both are the pseudo columns. It look like as a actual columns of the table, but that columns is not present in the table, but it act like as a table. Mirage, well, it's a very best example for the pseudo columns and views. Pseudo columns and views. Okay, so these are the pseudo columns. We'll see. So we don't have any things in this. Okay, I will share these documents. Okay, I will share these documents. Okay, we are left with the joins and views, indexes, joins and the views and the indexes. If we need 3 hours of time, totally. So we'll finish out the joins now. Anyone having any concern? No, right? So join is a condition. Join is a condition. So what the condition? What is the meaning of that condition? Now, star from employee. Select star from employee. Now we have the employee information in this table, and we have select star from DEPT. So DEPT table will maintain the department information. Employee table will maintain the employee information. Okay, and we have another table. Grade is another table. It contains the salary information with the grade wise. So if you want to provide the marks to the grade for the 10th class or intermediate people, you will get the grades, right? If you get the 95.95 to 100, you will get the 9.8, something like there is a range of values. If you get the 98 or 100 also, you will get the 9.8 till 99.9. So there is some range of values, low value and high value. Okay, if I want to get that, okay, so now we are make it like as a grades here. If I get the salary between 700 to 1200, so make it as a grade is 1. If I get the salary between 3000 to 999, Okay, we are making it as a grade is 5. Okay, treat like I say, this is my like 95 marks, this is 100. This is 80, 95. So you are providing the range of values. If you want to find out that, we will use the salary grade table to get the grades for the salaries. Okay, these three tables we have now. Now, in the department table, 10, 20, 30, 40. We have four department details here. How many employees we have? So now we can pin this output. Okay, now we can pin this output and make it as another group. Okay, new document tab group. Okay, now I copied in this. I'm running this. Now, treat like I say, this is a parent table, this is the child table. Okay, so parent ID is 1, 10, 20, 30, 40. We have four. So you can try with the create with the parent table and child table about your family. Maintain the family details table, family information, and maintain the parent table, child table. Put the relation between these two tables and get that information about after doing this. Okay, don't practice with employee table and the department table. Maintain like school's information, master detail. So master students. Okay, like that, doctor, patients. You can maintain in that way. Don't practice with this stupid employee table and department tables. Okay, now we have this employee information. Now, see, for every parent, there may be a child or not. Okay, so if it is the child, that child is in the alive in the sense, there must be a parent. Without parent, that child cannot come, right? Okay, so parents can, does not have the child also. If someone is getting married, he become like a parent. If you have a child or not, it won't bother about that. So married people, we can say it as a parent. So the guard is not provided the child for those guys. How the people will things. Okay, so now see, we have the four childs, four parents here. Out of four parents, we have here, see, 20 we have, 10 we have, 20 we have, 30 we have. We don't have 40. The 40th, you don't have any child. This is the child table. In the department, employees working, not in the employees, department is not there. So parents have the child. Okay, child have the parents, not the child have the parents. Got it? Now we'll see how to get the, now this is the employee information. Now I need to, this is like a child information. Now I need to get the parent information. Client is asked to pull that. This is the parent information. This is the child information. Now while displaying the child information, kindly display the parent information along with the parent information. Sorry, along with child information, display with the parent information as well. Okay, I need the employee information and department information. Now, select from EMP. Okay, so EPTD. Now, now the employee information is having in the employee table. Department table is having in the department table. Now if we want to retrieve the data from the both tables, we need to use the two tables, right? Without using the two tables, I cannot able to get the department information. Now I'm using that. So how many records we are getting? 50. How many we have? Total 56, because we are totally we have 56. Okay, how many records we have in this?
Four.
How many we have in the employee table? 14. So what is happening here? You know, matrix multiplication. Matrix multiplication, we have the concept like 1, 2, 3, 4. This is one matrix. 1, 2, 3. Okay, so else you can make it like I say 4, 5, 6. This is 2x2 matrix, this is 2x3 matrix. If you want to do the multiplication, I won't bother about if it is both column is having the common same matrix or not. You can able to multiply with the 1x1, with the 2x2, anything, 2x3 also you can able to. Okay, now meaning is this one will try to match with this one. Again, this 4, 2, 5, 3, 6. So for every one value, it will look for the, it will look for this. How many values we have? It can do the multiplication. 1 into 1, 1 into 4, 1 into 2, 1 into 5, 1 into 3, 1 into 6. It perform like how many distinct records we have. How many records, not the distinct. How many records we have? Here we have 14 records. So this first record can match with this like 14 times. And third record will link with the 14 times for 14 records. Okay. Fourth record also same. Okay. So 4 into 14, 56. So this we can say matrix multiplication like, right? So like cross join or Cartesian product. In the oracle also, we can make it like as a cross join or Cartesian product. Okay. This is the cross join. So you don't have, so how many we have the actually employees? 14. How many departments we have?
4.
So if you want to get the, if you want to get the employee information and department information, both also you need to get max 14 plus 4, 18 records max. So you are counting the people, you are counting the people, village 1 and village 2. Village 1 is having 10 people, village 2 is having 5 people. Now you are finding out, so here 5 into 10, 15 population. You are saying like the both villages having the 50 people. You don't have that many people, right? Actually, we have only 15 people. You are saying 50. It's a wrong. To get the correct results, to get the correct count from the tables, we'll use the joins. We'll use the joins. So now we use this tables, both tables. Village 1 and village 2 are table 1 and table 2. Simply mentioning the relation, putting the condition. E data department number equal to D data department number. Now we'll observe the results. We have the 14 records now. We have the 14 records now. See, if I use the star here, the system is not confusing anything about you. Okay, so see here, first it takes the data from the employee table. Okay, so till the department number, you got the data. Okay, so after completion of all columns of the employee table, and it can display the department, department table information. See, department number, D name, location. Department number, D name, location. Okay, if I use the star, that will happen. So you can able to identify, is there any common column from the both tables? If you have common member in the both villages, you can able to identify. He is the brother-in-law or son-in-law of this village. He is actual son of this village. You can able to identify. He is my son-in-law or brother-in-law, anything. He is my brother. He is brother-in-law. You can able to identify in that way. So now I am see here. Department number is having the common column from the both tables. Okay, so for that it is showing the duplicate department number underscore one. You are not counting this column, actual column. So you are make it like I said duplicate column. This department number underscore one. Okay, the system automatically maintain that. Now, what are the things we are performing here? Now I make it like I say column names. Now I copied that all column list and displaying this. Okay, I'm removing this duplicate column. Now I'm trying to display this. Column ambiguously defined. So the system is getting confusion. Okay, so the system is getting confusion. So this department number having the, so he is present in the village one and village two both. So I need to make sure that he is related to which village, village one or village two. I need to make sure that I make it like I say. So this is the village one treat like I say, E is the employee is the village. EMP is the village. DEP is another village. Now I'm referring it to the, he is related to the employee village. Now see, you won't get any data. So error, you won't get any error. Okay, now I'm collapsing this. See, we got the 14 employee information. Okay, now every child having the parent. Okay, I need to know which parent does not have child. That information also I need to display. So I'm mentioning like a department table. So this is the parent table is the first, child table is the later. Okay, now we are getting the which employee is having the department or which child is having the parent. That information you are getting here. Now I need to get the which parent does not have child, that information as well. So if the parent does not have child also, I need to display that. So which department does not have employees, that information also I need to retrieve. So for that, we need to use the outer joins. We have actually two joins, inner join and outer join. Whatever the join we use till now, that is inner join. So if you want to use the outer joins, we'll use that outer joins. So how can we use the outer joins? Simply put the plus in the brackets. If you want to use, we have the outer joins. Outer joins will help you to get the matching information, non-matching information. So whatever the employee table and the child table, department table and employee table is having the common. You are trying the common records matching. Okay, I need the non-matching information as well. If you have the common records from the both tables, common column, you will get the department information as well, parent information as well. Okay, if the parent does not have the child, you are displaying the parent details, but you don't have any child. You will display the null values for that. Because there is no child, right? You will display the null values for that. Now, see, I'm mentioning this in the first place. Make it like as a department wise I am taking now. Now, see, we have the department table and employee table, right? Now I make it like as a D dot. Now, see, now we have, this is the parent table, left side. This is the left table, this is the right table. This is left table, first table is the left. What the table is having the left side for you, that is the left. What the table is having right side, that is the right table. Okay, now we are using the joins. Left table column name equal to right table column name. Okay, now you are mentioning the right side plus symbol. Plus. So if you are using, if you want to make it like as a left outer join, you need to put the this plus symbol from the right side. Okay, so see, now we have the common information. We have the common information from this table. Okay, so we have the non-common or non-matching records. 40th does not have any employee, but you are getting that without having the matching information from the right side table. So this is about the outer join. Outer joins will help you to get the matching information along with the non-matching. If you have the matching information from the corresponding table, it will take the data from that corresponding table and display to us. If does not have the corresponding data from the table, it display the nulls for that. This way. Okay. So if you want to make it right outer join, the same table, right outer join, simply take that and put it in this left side. Now, every child having the parent, no child does not have parent. Everyone have the child, everyone have the parent. That's why you are getting the same result. Okay, now I need to find out. So any one of the child does not have the parent. Any parent does not have the child. Both cases are required. Both cases are required. So for that, left outer join and right outer join, I need to use. So I will go with the full outer join. We have another join like a full outer join. So now we make it like as a left side in the sense right side in the sense left side. We'll use the both left and right. We'll get the error. A predicate may be reference only one outer join for the table. So whatever the join you are putting on some table, you can able to use only one outer join. Only one outer join. Now the system is understanding like this is two outer join. This is the left outer join. This is the right outer join. Okay. Now to overcome this problem, we need to use this way. One left outer join with the union and the one right outer join with this. So now we have the 15 records. If I use the union all, we'll get the duplicates. We definitely we need to use, must and should we need to use the union. If I use the left child, to get the matching information and non-matching information from the left side, and the right side you get the matching. If you use the right, you will get the matching information from left side and non-matching and matching both from right side. If I use the union for that, output will same, right? If I have the common record, maybe in the left chain or right right chain, so you can get only one unique record. That's why we'll use the union. Okay, this is very difficult to write this, right? To simplify this joins concept, we have another way to write that. Simply mentioning like a inner join. Okay. Left outer join. Right outer join. Outer join. Okay, so inner join, left outer join, full outer join, right outer. So we need to use this way. So how can we use that? Same things. So if we want to what this is the left join. Right side we have the plus meaning in the sense. So let's say left outer join. So use this. So one table to another table, in between we need to mention the join, left outer join of whatever the condition you are mentioning in that where class. Where class, use it like on class. We no need to use any plus symbols here, simply mention that. 15, left outer join, what the table we have from the left side, it become like as a left outer join, left table. So you will get the 40th information as well with the blank details. Okay, right outer join, simply mention that. Full. Mention that full. No, definitely we need to make it like I said from both. Every place I used it. Department number. No, that's why I mentioned it. I need to take while displaying the data for us, need to consider the department number from the department table. So we need to use the E data. You will get the duplicate column now. See here, U is the department number directly column. But the column it is showing in the result, DEPT number underscore one. Meaning is the column is having duplicate. It's already present in the earlier. Okay, simply if you want to get the matching results, use the inner join. Okay, inner join. If you want to use, this is like a two tables. While putting the two table as a join, you are getting one join condition. If I use the two tables, three tables. Now, how can we put the join for that? Simply make it like it says. Now we have the inner join. Sal grade we have, right? Sal grade. Yes. E dot sal between S dot low sal and Okay, now we don't have any salary table column here. Now I am make it like I say grade. Here I can mention the grade. See, I'm not mentioning this grade column. I need to consider for which table. You are not mentioning, you are not referring that, because the grade person is not present anywhere. So he is not related to any village. If you have 10 villages, he is not present in any other village. He is having in only one village. So that's why the system automatically can understand. If the same name is having the duplicate within the any different villages, so the population the officer can get confusion to he is the person related to which village. అర్థమవుతుందా? ఏదైనా ఒక మెంబర్ ని నేను కౌంట్ చేసేటప్పుడు వాడు ఏ విలేజ్ కి సంబంధించిన వాడు నేను చెప్పాలి. ఓకే, చెప్పేటప్పుడు శివ అనేవాడు వీరికి ఒకడు ఉంటాడు. సో కంపల్సరీ ఆ శివ అని ఏ విలేజ్ కి సంబంధించిన వాడు నేను చెప్పాలి. XYZ అనే నేమ్ ఉందనుకో, ఆ XYZ అనే పేరు ఎవరికి ఉండదు. అప్పుడు హీ మే బి ఏ వన్ గాయ్ ఆఫ్ ది హోల్ వరల్డ్. నా యూ నో నీడ్ టు సే అబౌట్ దాట్ హీఈస్ రిలేటెడ్ టు దిస్ విలేజ్. వాడు ఈ విలేజ్ సంబంధించిన వాడిని చెప్పను అసలు. ఆటోమేటిక్గా వాడు ఆ విలేజ్ సంబంధించింది అక్కడ ఉంటాడని ఆటోమేటిక్గా సిస్టమ్ అర్థం చేసుకొని నీకు డేటా తెచ్చిస్తుంది. ఇఫ్ యూ మెన్షన్ దట్ ఎస్ ఎ గ్రేడ్, రైట్, ఏ స్టార్ట్ గ్రేడ్, ఇఫ్ యూ మెన్షన్డ్ ఆర్ నాట్ మెన్షన్డ్, the system won't bother about that, because there is no common record or common column in both the tables. But if you have the common records or common values, not the records, if you have the common columns, see, the department number is present in both tables. Department number present in the department table and the employee table, both. In that situation only, definitely, whatever the common columns we have more than one table, that columns you must and should be reference with a table name. Okay, so this is what. Now we are getting the data. See, now we are using three tables here. We are getting two joint conditions. If you have the five tables joints, you will get the four joint conditions. Okay, so if you have n tables, you will get the n minus 1. You will get the n minus 1 joints. Now see here. So how we put this joint, how this joints can work here. Department table and employee table is one table. So now you are mentioning this is one table, this is two table. You are make it like as a joint condition, you are joined with these two. Now these two table become like as a one table. Now this is the another table, this is the second table. Now these two table already become as a one table. Now you are making like as a another table with a one join. Okay, so if you have a n number of tables also, you can put that joins one by one. So make it like as a for every table need to be joined. Definitely we need to maintain some on conditions and maintain the joined things. Okay, this is the equi-joined. You are using the equal. This is equi-joined. This is the non-equi-joined. Other than the equal, what are the other operators if you are using? That you can call it as a non-equi-joined. So we have equi in the sense, equi join, non-equi join. Equi in the sense, whatever the joins we are using, left outer, right outer, inner, anything. If we are using that with the equal operator, that is equi join. If we are using the other than the equal, anything greater than, less than, between, anything, that we can call it as a non-equi joins. Okay, so these are all the joints concept. We are left with the only self join. We are left with only self join here. See, we'll finish it at that as well. Select star from employee. Okay, now in this employee table, we have the employee information, employee number, employee name, job. This is MGR. MGR in the sense manager ID. Who is the manager for you? That is the manager's employee ID. So employee information having with the manager information. Now you have only manager ID. So manager is also part of the same organization. So he is also one of the employee for that organization. He may be the boss for you, but he is the part of the employee of the same organization. Same organization. So now if we want to maintain, if we want to get the employee information along with manager information, you need to use the, to fetch the employee information one time, to fetch the manager information one time, we need to use the same table with the two times. Same table with the two times. That's why we can call it as a self join. Self join. The same table, if you are joining with the, again with the same table, that we can call it as a self join. When we'll use the self join? Treat like as an employee table. This. This employee table is having employee information along with the manager ID. Okay, if I want to display the employee information and manager information. Okay, so he is the manager, right? That manager information I want to pull that. So he 7698 is the manager, right? So 7698 is this employee Blake. So who is he? I need to identify. To fetch that information, I need to use manager in, to pull that manager information again, I need to use the same employee table. If you want to pull the employee information, I need to use the same employee table. If you want to get the manager information, that is also same employee table. How can we get that? Now, employee. Now I'm pulling the employee information. Mentioning treat like as an employee. Now, inner join. Okay, so inner join. So what we have, EMP M to fetch the manager detail. M on E data MGR equal to M data EMP number. So for you, you are asking to pull the manager information. You have the manager ID. Okay. So for that manager, from manager table, you are pulling that employee information. So for you, he is a manager, but for myself, he's working my organization. So he become like I say, my employee. So now I make it like I say, employee table as M to pull that manager information. Now check with this. We get the 13 employees here. One employee information does not have for you. Because, so see, for CEO is also one of the employee in the same organization. For the CEO does not contain any manager. He is the boss. So president. President does not have any manager information. That's why you are not getting. So still I need to display that. Use the left channel. So we haven't used outer here, left outer join. Outer is the optional keyword, system can understand automatically. See here, the president having the null values. Okay, this is about the joins. Okay, I will finish it out by tomorrow. Definitely I can finish it out by tomorrow. What day SQL? By day after tomorrow onwards, we can get started with the PL SQL. So if you want to see anything here, 1 minute. So see, we have simple join, equi join, inner join, everything will same. Equi in the sense, if we use the equal operator, that we can equi join, non-equi in the sense that. Okay, inner join, outer join. So, self join, everything will same. Use the inner join, we'll get the common records, matching records. This is intersect. Intersect will get the both sets as a one record, common information. Okay, so joins, inner join will get the first results plus second results. This is a horizontal or vertical? This is our, if you want to display the results horizontally, use the joins. If you want to display vertically as a one result, we'll go with the set operators, intersect, union, these are. Okay, so see, intersect, inner join will help you that. So we have another things, left outer join, see. From left side, you are getting the matching and non-matching both. From right side, you are getting only matching information. Okay, so I'm going to share this. This what are the things I have explained in this that we have already in this. Right outer join, full outer join. We'll get the from both as a full. Okay, now I'm giving some tasks for the people like now. We have some Excel sheet. I have the match scheduling thing. Now I have the teams like a teams. Okay, now we have team ID, team name like that. Okay, one, two, three. Like there is some name India, Pakistan, like that. Okay, now I need to schedule the matches. Schedules, schedule match. This is another table or another anything. I need a schedule match details. Like this country need to play with all the teams. 1 into 2, 1 into 3, 1 into 5, 1 into 4. Okay, this 2 needs to be match play with 2 into 1, 2 into 3, 2 into 4, 2 into 5. Okay, there is a chance to get the 1 into 1 also sometimes. I don't like, see, if you have okay, this is team A. Team 1. Team 2. Okay, so here we have some countries same again, like okay, now if I want to make the schedules 1 into 2, 1 into 1, 1 into 3. So I will get the, man, no, we have only one table, two table, team 1, team 2, like that, anything. Now we have this table. Now I need the schedules for this. I need to make it the schedules. Okay. Prepare the schedule and get that results by tomorrow. I need the results like 1 into 1, 1 into 2, 1 into 3, 1 into 4, 1 into 5, 2, 1, 2 into 1, 2 into 1, 1 into 2, 2 into 1, both are same. You won't put any duplicate schedules. Got it? Result. No, I have only one table. Team table. I need to make it as a country table, man. Treat like as a country table. Okay, I need to make the schedule for that all countries, whatever the countries we have in that particular country table. Create the country table. and make it some schedules for that. Okay, A country match with B. So B can B can play with again A. So I'm not allowing that. I don't need the duplicates. So if I play with you, you play with me, both are same, right? I don't need that duplicate schedules. Anyone having any doubt? I'm stopping there. Nice.